Now, to solve this problem inherent in all of the magnetic motor designs, I've been looking at the Halbach Array. Now, the interesting thing about this is it proves it is possible to cycle the spins. Now, Halbach arrays are used for many different things. One of the most simplistic would be an assembly like this would be used for refrigerator magnets. By arranging the magnets in this particular configuration, it blocks out most of the fields on this one side and amplifies them in the other direction. Therefore, this side would stick to the refrigerator, the other side would not. When you use this in a rounded or arced configuration, it makes it possible to finally cycle the spins. And that's been the main problem in trying to get one of these magnetic motors to work from anybody that actually understands what they're doing and what's actually wrong, what the main design flaw is in what they're doing. By cycling the spins, what this does, if you've watched any of my other videos, the problem with the assemblies that you use in these magnetic motors, whether it be a linear motor or a rounded arced geometry motor, you're basically creating one longer magnet. And once you get past the repulsion in the opening, it'll accelerate to the end. But you can't cycle that in a rounded version. Now, something configured like this, you can cycle the spins. And therefore, you can get around that design flaw if you can incorporate this into your design. Perhaps use this configuration around your assemblies, or something to that effect. But this principle, if used properly, I believe, would make a magnetic motor possible. Now, the first thing I'm going to do here is kind of rule out the obvious. This is a basic Halbach array configuration. What I'm going to do is I'm going to mount this on a rotor, the north facing one way, the south the other, give it a spin, and just demonstrate that this alone is not enough to be able to build a rotating motor. Nor will this be. Here I've got some weaker magnets. I've glued them together so that the same poles are facing out. I'm going to mount that on a rotor and show that this also, in itself, is not enough to build a magnetic motor from this type of configuration. I think what it's going to come down to is trying to employ this type of configuration with another design, like assemblies that are pieced together with these type of configurations, capping off the assemblies or something to that effect. Hey, this is my initial test of the rotor assembly for the Halbach array design here. This particular configuration is definitely not what I'm going to use later. It basically just bounces around in here. But I thought it might be worth a try. This configuration is also going to be a no. Interestingly, if you use these smaller magnets, which have about 70 pounds of pull pressure, it doesn't matter whether you orient it as a north or as a south. It stabilizes in the field. A dual configuration there. Now, this is the beginning of my attempt to incorporate the Halbach Array into one of my own assemblies. Using it to cap it off, and I'll continue this all the way around. Interesting thing to note, if you've watched any of my previous videos, one of the things that I've pointed out is, unless you can start a rotor or a cart at different points in your magnetic assembly and get it to accelerate all the way out to the end, it just simply won't work. The interesting thing about this is, so far, you can do that. Now, whether that will continue on, that's another story. But it at least shows some promise. Anyway, that's where it stands right now. And that's going to be the end of this part of the video. Thanks for watching.